Well, it's time to answer some of your email questions on this Money Monday. And Pat, this first one is from Joey, who says, after a six-month job search, I have finally been offered a job. It's a lot less money than my previous position and not really something I want to do, but it is a job. Is it fair to the employer to accept the job, but knowing that I really want something better?
Oh, Joey, what's in your heart's in your heart. But if he's asked you specifically, will you stay around for a while, and you say, yes, I will, then and you intend to leave, and that's a lie. You don't, can't do that. Yeah. But
on the other hand, what's in your hand is in your hand. You know, if you need a job.
The guy's offering you a job, and you work hard at the job, and you get paid for what you're doing. And if sometime in the future, a couple of years down the road, you find something better, then you leave. That happens all the time. Nothing dishonest about it. Yeah. Only if in the interview they say, will you stay with the company? And you say yes when you know you're not. Then that's lying. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, this is Keith, who says, summer vacation is only a little over a month away, and we want to take our family of five on some kind of vacation. Do you have some suggestions for some less expensive options we could consider?
You know, the state parks are really wonderful. For example, West Virginia has a number of just marvelous state parks. They have cabins that you can rent that are practically for free. They've got swimming and canoeing and hiking and all kinds of nice things. You can have outdoor campfires and kind of really have a bonding
experience.
Did you
camp with your kids when they were growing up?
Yes, not as much as I would have liked to, but I did some. Mm-hmm.
That's always a little less expensive, I think, than getting a hotel room.
What you can do is get a pop-up trailer and haul it around someplace and set up in a... But I tell you, up in Canada is the place they've got the most glorious camps.
It is public. Beautiful up there.
And beautiful white beaches and sand and hardly anybody there. I mean, they really are lovely. So, I mean, hey, that's good. So that's just some suggestion.
This is Bruce, who says, a career seminar I attended suggested always carrying some business cards to help me find a job. I confess I've never had business cards, and I'm not sure how or to whom I give them. Is there a certain business card etiquette?
Well, they sort of say it is. If you know, when you're in Asia, for example, everybody has cards and everybody gives cards. In order to give cards, you've got to hold it up with both hands. If you hold it up with one hand, it's an insult. You have to have both hands with your card and you bow. But here in the States, the etiquette is, if the other guy gives you a card, you give him a card. If somebody asks for your card, you give him a card, but you don't shove cards at him. On the other hand, having met somebody, you can write him a letter, thank him for the visit, and include a card in your letter.
That's a good idea.
Get something nice. It doesn't cost that much to have a pretty card that tells who you are. Yeah. You know,
you can actually print them out on your own computer now.
Well, yeah.
You know, it's
well,
simple.
You know, John Smith, Vice President of Frou Frou, you know, whatever.
You can be president of anything you want.
Be a better president of nonsense. All right, go on.
Okay. This is Paige, who says, what is the rule of 72? Someone tried to explain it to me once, but all I can remember is that it has something to do with interest. Can you explain it to me?
That's a fundamental law. It's so easy. It tells you how many years it takes for money to double if it's compounding. If you compound your money, in other words, you got interest and then you have interest on interest and so forth, you take the interest that you're compounding, say it's 8%, and it takes you 9 years for your money to double. If you've got it at 20%, for example, it'll double in 3.5 years. I mean, that's the way it is. It's a real simple formula. You just divide 72 by the interest rate that you are compounding, not just interest, but it's got to compound, and it'll double your money. All right.
Okay, this is Erin, who says, when my friend was laid off recently, she announced that she would just live off her emergency fund. I'm concerned for her because she isn't cutting back any expenses, and that money will not last longer than a couple of months. Am I out of line to talk to her about this, or should I just pray that the Lord provides her with another job quickly?
Erin, go put your arm around the friend and say, dear, let me tell you something about the reality. You know, or just say, I'm concerned about you. I mean, if you're concerned.
If you're sincere, I think she would
receive. Yeah, I'm concerned.
That.
I'm not trying to meddle in your affairs, but I'm concerned. I want to make sure that your money will last. And in order to afford it to last, you're going to have to cut back what you're doing and make it, you know, last a little longer. If you have an emergency fund, it may be just be for 3 or 4 months. Yeah. That might not hold them. All right.
Okay, this is April, who says, "Dear Pat, you suggested using coupons at the grocery store, and it has helped me stretch my food dollars. I've noticed, though, that some of the coupons are labeled, quote, 'do not double.' Why does a manufacturer care if the store doubles them for me?"
Well, if they double them and try to get the manufacturer to pick up the tab, I think that's what the manufacturer's trying to say. You know, you'll get it one time, you're not going to get it two or three times, but many stores will double and they'll triple what's on the coupon. So it depends on where you get them and what specifics are said. I understand if you print your own with a computer, you're not going to get anything doubled, but a lot of coupons will double. But the manufacturer's essentially trying to protect himself or itself from extra charges.
Well, that's all the time we have for your money.
You don't, do you? After all the time you've been on this program.
Not because I don't think that they're sometimes valid. Listen, if I had a nickel for every coupon that has sat at the bottom of my purse or in the ashtray of my car, and then I go into the store, forget I have them, and I mean, it's just...
We've had people on who've gotten $150 worth of groceries for free with coupons.
When I've used them, I find I sometimes buy things that I would not normally buy.
I'm buying
it because it's less expensive, not because it's something I'd buy normally. So I don't know what I think about coupons.
A super jug of picante sauce.
Yeah,
but I don't use picante.
It's still on the shelf three years later.
Yeah. Right. Okay. So much for Terry and coupons, but they are good to save you money.